Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel All About BI. So for the past two sessions we have been discussing about triggers, okay, how to create event based triggers, for example when a blob is created or blob is deleted, how to trigger the pipeline or schedule a pipeline at a particular day or week or month at a specific time and all. So we have discussed all this in previous sessions. So this session is going to be about tumbling window triggers. So what are the differences between tumbling window trigger and schedule trigger, and where and all we'll have to be using this tumbling window trigger, that is what we are going to concentrate in this session. All right, so we'll go to adf.azure.com and we'll add a trigger. Okay, in this add trigger option you will have option to create a new trigger or use already created triggers, right? So the types of the trigger we have already seen, there are three types: schedule, tumbling window and event. Okay, with respect to schedule type of trigger, right, you can schedule a particular pipeline to be run from a particular start date to an end date, recurring every minute or hour or day or month or week, okay. But with respect to tumbling window trigger, right, you won't be seeing these many options. When I choose this, right, you will have only just minutes and hours, okay. So this is the first difference between schedule triggers and tumbling window triggers. Second, when and all we'll be using this tumbling window trigger when compared to schedule trigger. Or schedule trigger doesn't have much option with respect to creating dependencies between triggers or with respect to concurrency. Okay, so the main differences would come to place when you have to process your data in the past. Okay, for example, you have a pipeline created, but you have to make that pipeline pick up certain records in the past. Okay, you have a database from which you are going to do a copy activity, but from the database you have to pick up a certain records only for a certain time period. For example, you have a database db1 and then a table tbl.1, right, tbl1. So you, from this table 1, you have to pick up records wherein the start time and end time are in the past. Okay, so this is one scenario wherein we'll be going for tumbling window trigger. You can create a schedule trigger for the past, but it is not going to take the pipeline to the past and going to execute the pipeline for the past time window. Okay, schedule triggers will run from the moment you're triggering the schedule and publishing the changes. Okay, but tumbling window trigger can take you to the past and bring data for a specific time period in the past. So this is the first difference that we'll have to be knowing about tumbling window triggers. Okay, if you have to work in the data on the past, then go for tumbling window trigger. All right, need to have dependency means you have a couple of triggers in place. Okay, trigger 1, trigger 2, or trigger A or trigger B or whatever be it, right? So if you have to make sure trigger 2 executes only on successful completion of trigger 1, right, then you can go for tumbling window trigger. Okay, so how can we create these dependencies? There is an option in the tumbling window trigger to do this. Okay, when you come to tumbling window trigger, you can go to advanced tab wherein you can add dependencies. Okay, so this is the second difference that is making a difference when it comes to schedule trigger and tumbling window trigger. So creating dependencies. Okay, all right, what else? There is one more thing with respect to concurrency. Okay, with respect to tumbling window trigger, you will be seeing something called concurrent. With respect to past data and all, right, for example, we are again coming back to the first example. From table 1, we'll have to create or we'll have to pull records from the past for various windows. When I say windows, right, today it's September 10th, I guess. September 11. Okay, so I'm creating a tumbling window trigger for the past. For example, August 11th. From August 11, every 1 hour we'll have to execute a particular pipeline. Okay, so when we schedule it for 24 hours, right, one day 24 hours, you will have 24 windows created. In the sense, from August 11 12 to 1 a.m. there will be one window, 1 to 2 a.m. there will be another window, 2 to 3 a.m. there will be another window. So like this you will have 24 windows created. Okay, so when we are accessing the past records, right, then we need not make the pipeline sequential. For example, you need not wait for 12 to 1 a.m. trigger or window to complete before this 1 to 2 a.m. completes, because everything is in the past only. Okay, there is no need for you to wait for one particular window slice to complete before the another window slice executes or triggers. Okay, in this scenario, right, we can make the concurrency as 24. The sense all the 24 time slices are going to be executed at once, parallelly, I'm telling. Okay, so we have seen about accessing the data on the past and then having dependencies among trigger 1 and trigger 2 and having concurrency. Okay, cover something about this dependency. In Microsoft site itself, they have given a beautiful example of when and all we can be using this dependency and how this dependency works. Okay, so you have trigger A and trigger B. Alright, so trigger A is dependent on trigger B, in the sense trigger A will be executed based on the execution status of trigger B. Okay, when we say offset is minus 1 hour and size is unspecified, right? So these triggers, every trigger A and trigger B, these are all having a time slice of 1 hour from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. But before trigger A's 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. portion can execute, it will verify whether 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. portion of trigger B has executed or not. Okay, only if 9 to 10 a.m. of trigger B has executed successfully, we will execute 10 to 11 a.m. of trigger A. Okay, offset minus 1 in the sense the current trigger is dependent on the previous hour or previous 1 hour's status of the other trigger. Okay, when you say minus 2, right, then it will trigger A's 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. will be depending on 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. of trigger B. So offset determines which portion of the dependent trigger has to be executed before you are executing the current trigger. Okay, so in this example, right, we are mentioning offset to be minus 1 hour, which means 10 to 11 a.m. portion of trigger A will be executed only if trigger B's 9 to 10 a.m. So in this case, we haven't mentioned any size. Okay, so here we are mentioning a size to be 2 hours. Okay, in the sense your trigger A's 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. will get executed only when the trigger B's 9 to 11 a.m. has executed successfully. Okay, so this portion will wait until the whole portion of trigger B has completed. Okay, that is what you are mentioning the size here. Alright, so self-dependency is nothing but, see, for example, we created a tumbling window trigger for a pipeline to execute 24 hours time period for 24 hours, and every 1 hour we should execute it. So there will be 24 windows, correct? 24 windows starting from 12 midnight to 12 a.m. to 1 a.m., 1 a.m. to 2 a.m. and so on, 2 a.m. to 3 a.m. and all, we can have time slices or windows created. Okay, when in your pipeline, if this 1 a.m. to 2 a.m. portion depends on 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. portion, right, then you can have dependency, self dependency created in the same pipeline. In our case, right, it need not be trigger A or trigger B. Okay, it can be trigger A and trigger A itself. Okay, for example, this 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. portion will get executed only when 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. has executed successfully. In that case, you should be mentioning the offset as minus 1. Okay, so these are all the benefits or different advanced features that you can make use of when you are creating a tumbling window trigger. Okay, so that is what I wanted to cover today. I'll be showing a demo as well. In upcoming session, I'll be showing you a live demo how this dependency works. Okay, for now, just understand that we can have dependencies created among the pipeline itself when you can create a tumbling window trigger, which is not doable when you're doing a schedule trigger. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you have any doubts about this, please let me know in the comment section. And if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot.